Howdy y'all, it's JM, RealGuysReviews. Well, said when I did the little video on the generalities of cleaning guns, we weren't going to do a specifics, but my son was out today and put about 300 rounds of lead through these, so I sat down to clean them and thought, you know, what the heck? Everybody else has got a gun cleaning video out there. Thought I'd just show you how I do it. So what I'm going to do is simply turn the camera on, clean these guns, and just talk to you as I do it. So this is a real deal on getting these cleaned because they're all dirty. We've got the Ruger SR9c, Glock 23, and the Pitbull. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put a little ballistol in this Pitbull here. Let it soak a little bit. Get that down there. I'm not going to use Hoppy's tonight because he's going to shoot again tomorrow. So I'm just simply going to go through these with ballistol, get them good and clean, and see if we can't get them ready for him tomorrow. So got the magazine already out. This is the Glock 23. You can see we're nice and empty, so we'll break the slide down on it. Didn't quite get it down, did I? Okay. Now we got her off. Now this has, be a little careful, this has a little bit lighter spring, recoil spring that I put in. Since this is a conversion, this is a Lone Wolf 40-9 conversion. Don't have any trouble with it, but it kicks the cases out a little bit better with that. I'm going to go ahead and replace it back with a standard Glock recoil spring tonight after I get it clean. So I'll do the same thing with this little barrel. We're going to getting all soaked up with ballistol, let it be doing its thing. And tell you what I think I'll do, this little gun, just to show you, it is empty. We're going to set him aside. And I'm not going to mess with it right now, so we're just going to do these two, because these are the two that he's going to shoot tomorrow. He's not going to shoot the SR9C, and I may clean it a little bit later. Okay, well, let's get after this little revolver now and get him clean. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to run a few these little patches through it first. Okay, got that done. Excuse me 1 minute. I'm going to get my trash can over here just a little bit closer and toss all this stuff in it. So we'll run a couple of more through it. Absolutely get some of this stuff out of there. Well, it's not too bad. The other thing I'm going to do, since we've shot lead through this thing today, we'll go ahead and run a little brush through this too. We'll run this little soft brush through it. You know, revolver's got a lot of stuff to clean. Takes actually a little bit longer to do a revolver than it does to do the pistols. So we'll get this little brush through it. I'm not going to run the brass brush through this tonight. I'm just going to kind of get it clean a little bit with get him ready to shoot it tomorrow. The other thing I like to do, good old toothbrushes. Let's see, one of these is my ballistol, and the other one's my Hoppy's. This is a ballistol toothbrush. Lots of stuff on here. Ballistol's all over the place. It's a nice way to clean back up in here. Opening of the chamber here, the back part of it. Clean this out good. We accidentally get something back here where that firing pin is. Keep that good and dry. And I'll scrub that out in just a little bit with a dry toothbrush, but not with a damp toothbrush. So we'll take our little ballistol brush and just scrub everywhere. Get to scrub back up in this little area here. Get all that out of there. Make sure there's no carbon deposits back in there. And again, we're going to do a moderate cleaning. Get him ready to shoot tomorrow. So all these guns work nicely for him. Nothing like a good old rag, is there? Get it all cleaned out good. It's looking not bad. Another thing, works real nice. Let's slip up here and get a little paper towel action for this. Again, make sure firing pin area is good. We'll take a little dry toothbrush and get after that pretty good. Okay, so it gets the firing pin looks good and clean back in there. Mm-hmm, not bad. Nothing in there. Got that area clean and scrubbed real good. That cleans out real good with a little ballistol brush. And again, if I come back through after he shoots tomorrow and use the hops or hoppice, I'll do the same thing with it. Let me kind of get it right back in there a little bit better. Yep. And then I'll finish off right at the end with the ballistol. Sometimes use CLP, interchange that. But I'll always finish, I use hoppice with ballistol to lubricate. Ballistol and CLP, I think, are excellent lubricants. Hoppice is not really a lubricant as far as I think. Okay, so let's just run this back through. And see, right now, the nice thing about this is while we're doing all of this, the Glock barrel is soaking, and that's good. With ballistol and CLP, I think soaking's a little bit better with it for a while, and perhaps it needs to be with a hoppice solution. But it's soaking, it'll be ready to clean, scrub him out in a minute while we're finishing up. A little revolver, it's not exactly like we want. Again, we're not gonna have it maybe shining all over. We're definitely going to have the lead and most of the carbon deposits out of all of the chambers and out of the barrel. We'll have it nice and clean. Let's just take a little peek down there with the light and see. Yep, looking pretty good. Just sift one more through there. I think that will probably get us ready. Get him all prepared tomorrow so he's got a functioning gun. It's a little chilly today. We were, gosh, down about 42 degrees here in North Texas. Wind blowing out of the north at 15 to 20. Gonna be in the 20s tonight. It's kind of a welcome relief, actually, after the month of 100 plus degrees we had this summer, and after about 6 months of literally no rain. So we've been having a little bit of a wet winter, which is kind of nice. This is really the first cold spell we've really had. But you know, it doesn't bother us shooting, does it? I mean, we just get back over here with my little dry brush. We just dress up, get out there and shoot. He was shooting mostly still today. He likes that. That's a lot of fun, shooting still. Get that feedback of the ping and the little gong feedback. It's kind of nice. Looks good. Barrel's looking good. Just kind of check things out here. Maybe a tiny bit of carbon there, not bad at all. I think that little Pitbull is just about ready to shoot a little bit more steel tomorrow. So what we've done, the ballistol is real nice. Now the gun is nicely lubricated. Nothing's back here around the firing pin area, but it's good and clean. Barrel's lubricated in and out. Our ejector system's nicely clean. So this little guy is ready to go tomorrow. And if he doesn't shoot again for a couple of days while he's here visiting us, I'll probably do a little bit harder scrubbing with it with a couple of the solutions. So y'all, that's the revolver cleaning. That's how I do it. Works for me. So we're gonna put this aside. We'll put it back over here with our little SR9c. We're not gonna clean it tonight. And let's see what we've got here with our Glock. Alright, well, let me set the important mechanism down and we'll start with our barrel. Yeah, we got that nice and soaked, so let's God, we got bowling, we got a little bowel stall everywhere here, so we'll just get after this with our little ballistol brush. It works so nice. Paper towels are cheap, aren't they? Let's get us another one. Let's do it. Okay. Alrighty. Same thing. We're going to be... He probably put 200 of those through this today. So I'll make absolutely sure. Let's just squirt a little bit more here. A little bit more on our brush. That lead out of this thing. Okay, and I am going to take one little squig or two here with a soft brass. Yeah, I'm just pretty compulsive because of the lead situation. Don't like for it to sit around in my barrels. Now, as I talked to you on the general cleaning video, the one that was where we said this is not a standard cleaning video, this little solution here, at least once a month I'm shooting a lot of lead. I'm going to soak it in this 50-50 vinegar peroxide solution. As I told you before, got that mixture off of the Precision website and it does work. I have no earthly idea how the chemical reaction happens and does it, but it does it and it does help clean the guns. And let's take a little piece of wire around the barrel and then hook it over the edge of this, let it soak for about 20-30 minutes. It works pretty darn good. So what we've done here is we've let this barrel soak for a little bit while we clean the revolver, and then run a soft brush through it, run a little bit of brass brush through it, and a little pretty compulsive since he put a lot through it. We're getting there. It looks pretty darn good. So I think we're about through with that. We've got the neck and throat all nice and clean with our toothbrush, and the nice thing about it, again, this little barrel's lubricated with the ballistol. Okay. So we'll just set him right here on our little green rag and let's go ahead and wipe this down a little bit. Again, I did this mainly for him today. I wanted to make sure that he didn't have any issues with the recoil spring, with the ejecting out of there. You hear a little whine. I've got the labs back there in their little houses for the night. They're kind of like, what's going on over there? They don't hear me talking all that much. So we're going to put this up, and I'm going to put the standard Glock recoil spring back in this when we get through. All right, so let's now take our slide. And again, we're kind of dry clean. Everything's going to be dry that we do back here at the firing pin area. Get all the old carbon out of there. Yeah, I don't mind putting a little squirt up in there, and we'll get our soaked toothbrush back there. Clean that out. And our rags. Get them all cleaned out pretty good here. I'm going to leave a lot of this on there. It doesn't hurt the front of the slide at all. It'll be nice and lubricated, but the more liquid you have, the more dirt and grime sticks. Now, it's not a huge deal up there because, I'll tell you one thing I do. First of all, I enjoy it, so it's not a big deal. But I never, I will say this. I never shoot without cleaning my guns. If I'm going to go back and shoot maybe the afternoon. I shot a little bit in the morning on a weekend. I might just scrub out the barrel real good and wipe down the gun some, but I just don't believe in shooting and not cleaning the guns. You get dirt and grime different places. Get a little brush here. Looks good. Don't see any carbon deposits in there. Sometimes we, if we see some little areas we can't get to real good, it's nice to take a little Q-tip and get down in some of these little spots. It works real nice. I think that slide looks good. I think he'll be happy with that tomorrow. This recoil spring, I'll just kind of go through a little bit because it's been sitting up, but it's not dirty. I cleaned it before I put it up. And again, this is a standard 23 40 caliber recoil spring. I had a little bit lighter one in since I have that this gun converted from 40 to 9. So he's shooting 9 millimeters. Okay, let's just see what we got here. It didn't look bad at all, but I'm going to put up my little ballistol brush. We're going to go totally dry here. Get back in here and get this carbon out. Everything is kind of nice. I lost my little brush down in there. We'll find him later on. Wipe that out. Take a little air. Carbon down in there, we'll get that blown out some. That's about all I'm going to do there. That looks pretty good. Not bad at all. What I am going to do is, before we get her back together, put a little lubricant on the slide mechanism. That works nice. And you know, really, we've pretty much got this taken care of. That didn't take much. Cleaned pretty good. There was a moderate amount of carbon in there, but it's not nearly as dirty as I thought. Now, he shot probably, gosh, I bet half of the rounds he shot were precision. And the precision is a poly-coated lead bullet that shoots just as clean, in my opinion, as the copper does. Okay, and that looks pretty good. So what we're going to do, we'll get this little barrel back in. And it's nicely lubricated, ready to go. Fits right in there nicely. And this time, again, we're going to go in with our standard recoil spring, not the little weaker one. All right, very nice. Let's see if we can get this back together. I bet we can somehow. I can slide around there. That's pretty good. Pretty easy. So guess what? We have got these two guns cleaned. Magazine wise, let's see what we've got here. I'm not going to take this down. Yeah, I like the magazine, especially the Glock one. It's just, no, it's supposed to be not that bad to get off. You just have to work it out with a little Glock pin device, but we'll get them clean here, and then I will break down and take this thing apart one of these days and clean them out real good. But it's functioning well, so we're in good shape. So here we are, everybody. We've got the, let's move that down. We've got the Glock all ready to go. We've got our little Pitbull 40 ready to go. Well, as you know, I set the SR9c over here and was not going to clean it, but I just got word that it's going to get shot again tomorrow, so I want to make sure and get all the carbon out of it. So let's go ahead and take this thing down, clean the barrel at least a little bit, and go over the gun some, get the little pin out of there. Now we've got to push down. Okay, got him down there. This little pin, pull that up and show you, that's got to go down to get our slide off. And then it'll come off nice and smooth. If you don't do that, it will come off still, but not nice and smooth. Better not to try to just jerk it off without that pin going down. Slide does not look bad. Just starting out with it. Well, I'll tell you what I better do. While we clean that, let me put a little bit of ballistol in here. Let it soak a little bit. This gun didn't get shot a lot today, but just enough with some lead. It'd be nice to go ahead and get it cleaned out a little bit. There's not much going on back up in here. So I'll give it a better scrubbing tomorrow. Just make sure there's absolutely nothing one creating a problem. Back up there, we got that looks good. Let's kind of make sure the frying pan area is good. Dry brush, dry clean brush. Okay, that looks good. No big deal with the slide. We'll all greased up. We'll put a little goop on there. Get this little gun out of the way and get these things up here where we can deal with them. Okay, before we, I think we go ahead and get this barrel taken care of here. I got stuff everywhere though. Well, that was good. See, there's not a lot in this barrel. It's creating much trouble. We will go ahead though, get that up there and get that out of the way. Tell you what we'll do. We'll just move a few of these clean guns out. And I'm going to drift this little brass brush through here a couple of times just to make absolutely sure I'm getting the lead deposits out. And that's already looking good. But we'll drift one more time through it just to make sure these little patches. Good. About all we need to do. And take our little ballistol brush. Make sure this throat neck area is good. It's already nice and clean. That's not much of a problem back there. Barrel's clean. You know, the nice thing about it, even after we've come through this with our patches, you know with the ballistol that we're lubricated. So we don't have to worry about that. Now if I clean this with Hoppus, I'd come right back through with ballistol or CLP, one final little run through just to make sure we're lubricated nicely. So I think that we just about got that one ready for him. That didn't take much. So take our little, take what I'll do here. Put this out so we got ballistol here, don't get it all over everything. I mean, you already see we've already gotten it all over everything. So let's get her back together. See if we can do that with some kind of irregularity. I bet we can. Yeah, let's see what we do here. Yeah, we put it in the right way, that would help, wouldn't it? Okay, got her. Got her little pin down so it's out of the way, not in the way of anything. Get her little this little pin back in, pop him in place, and our little Ruger is ready to run. Okay, we'll check its little magazine right quick. Again, it didn't get worked over very good today. Not going to take it apart either. And I think this is ready to go, so I do believe our little Ruger is ready to go. This magazine has to go in the right way, and it just goes a lot smoother that way. All I got left to do is clean the bench up a little bit, and before we take off here, I will use a little D-wipes, get my hands wiped down after I get everything taken care of so I don't carry lead into the house and get it all over everything. Well, that's a little bit more detailed of how I clean guns. Kind of went through that pretty quick. I enjoyed it. So that's just about it, y'all. Have a good one, and we'll see you at Real Guys Reviews. Thanks.